This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I think that's the last thing I'm going to say about this, and then I'm going to go ahead and rejoice in the Lord for today. The scripture says in Proverbs 29:18, without a vision, the people perish. Without a vision, the people perish, okay? The vision, which is the seed, gives life. It bears fruit. If there is no vision, there is no fruit coming forth. There is no life coming forth. There is no, production. It has to start from something. God only trusts his vision to certain people to carry it. He only trusts his vision to certain people to carry it. Whoever he trusts to carry it, it's up to you to protect it. Okay? People perish. Now you may be the one carrying the vision, but multiple people will reap the fruit of the vision. Multiple people will have life because of the vision. Just like Jesus was the one who was buried into the ground. He was the one who was crucified, buried, and resurrected. But many of us share in the faith. Through faith, we share in his resurrection. We share life. We share in his power. We share in his suffering. We share everything in it. Okay? So in your vision, you may be the one carrying it. It may be planted in your soil, but many people are dependent on this vision. Many people are dependent on this vision, but they have to have faith. If they don't have faith, they will not be able to reap the benefits of it. Without faith, they cannot reap the benefits of it. Okay? So if you got somebody who's always antagonizing you about the vision, I don't care how gently they antagonize you about it. I don't care how cunning or charming they seem to do. If they're always questioning you about it, don't you have faith with God put in you? If God got faith in you, why don't you got faith in you? Where is your lack of faith coming from, okay? God have faith in you because he put the vision in your soil. And he's gave you everything that you need up until this point. So who is somebody else to come and always question you about what? Why didn't he just give them the vision? Okay? So I just encourage you to pray on it. To just pray on it. It's really in my spirit today. It's really in my spirit today. I don't know why. But Lord, let your will be done in earth as it is in heaven. And I plead the blood of Jesus against any principality, any spiritual wickedness, any rulers of the dark, any powers that does not agree with the power of God. I plead the blood of Jesus, the powerful blood of Jesus, the victorious blood of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, that you are already victorious over all of the powers that come against us, Father God. I plead the blood of Jesus against them, Father God. I pray that you will give us vision, Lord, to see the snares and traps of the enemy, to see the spirits behind the temptations and the people that come as wolf in sheep clothing, Father God. Give us the spirit of discernment, Father God. Help us not to be distracted on the wrong things, Father God. But help us, Father God, to see in the spirit, Father, the weapons that are trying to form against us. Help us to see the bad seeds, Father, in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.